Good morning. Good morning, love. It's my favorite love song. I waited all night long.
Morning, everybody. Welcome back to Brekkie Bar. Up to chapter 16 of Whip today. Robert, you can kick us off today.
Yahusha said to his followers, once there was a rich man. He had hired a manager to take care of his business. Later, he learned that his manager was cheating him. He called the manager in and said to him, I have heard bad things about you. Give me a report of what you have done with my money. You can't be a manager anymore. So the manager thought to himself, what will I do? The master is taking my job away from me. I am not strong enough to dig ditches. I'm too proud to be to beg. I know what I will do. I will do something to make friends. When I lose my job, they will come at me, welcome me in their homes.
Thank you. Pina?
So the manager called in each person who owed the master some money. He asked the first, how much do you owe my master? He answered, I owe him 100 jars of olive oil. The manager said, here is your bill. Hurry, sit down, make the bill less. Write 50 jars. Then the manager asked another one, how much do you owe my master? He answered, I owe him 100 measures of wheat. Then the manager said, here is your bill. You can make it less. Write 80 measures. Later, the master told the dishonest manager that he had done a smart thing. Yes, worldly people are smart and more shrewd in their business dealing with each other than the spiritual people of light are.
Mikey, you continue on.
I tell you, use the worldly things you have now to make friends for later. Then, when those things are gone, you will be welcomed into a home that lasts forever. Whoever can be trusted with small things can also be trusted with big things. Whoever is dishonest in little things will be dishonest in big things too. If you cannot be trusted with worldly riches, you will not be trusted with the true riches. And if you cannot be trusted with the things that belong to someone else, you will not be given anything of your own. But remember, you cannot serve two masters at the same time. You will hate one master and love the other, or you will be loyal to one and not care about the other. You cannot serve Yahuwah and money at the same time.
What do you guys get from that parable?
If you're not trustworthy with the small things of the world and things in the world, then you can't be trusted with spiritual gifts and so on. You should use it.
Be good? Yeah. That basically says that, doesn't it? Whoever is dishonest with the little things will be dishonest with the big things too. So the little things are the things that Yahusha gives us every day to do. Yeah? The washing the dishes, doing the washing, the cooking. The setting the table, emptying the dishwasher, packing it. They're the little things. They're the tasks that you don't really like to do much. True?
Yeah, definitely.
And they're all the little things. So, if we can't be trusted to do those little things, how can we be trusted to do the bigger things that Yahushua's got planned?
We can't.
We can't, can we? So, we can see what Yahushua's saying to us in there. He wants to be able to trust us. And we have to prove that we are trustworthy. Yeah?
Mm.
Johnny, you want to continue on from him, buddy?
Yeah. I just wanted to see what the that verse, if that verse was accurate.
Yeah.
I tell you, use the worldly things you have now to make friends. Friends for later. What do I want friends for later for? I want to look at it in the BYNB.
Oh yeah, and what's it saying that?
I would say to you, make friends for yourselves by unrighteous riches, that when you fail, they shall receive you into everlasting dwellings. Hmm. Make friends for yourselves by unrighteous riches, that when you fail, they shall receive you into everlasting dwellings. What does that mean?
Make friends with Yahushua.
Unrighteous.
Make friends for yourselves by unrighteous riches. What are the unrighteous riches that we going to do every day?
Work, greed, all that. Money.
Money. Nothing to do with Yahushua, really. Just to pay the bills, all that stuff you got to do every day. Use that to make friends. So that when you fail, they shall receive you into their everlasting dwellings. If you've made friends from them, you might bring them into the kingdom. Does that make sense?
Hmm.
So we should use everything at our disposal. Interesting. I just hadn't heard that verse before. Use the worldly things you have to make friends for later. Then when those things are gone, you will be welcomed into a home that lasts forever. Well, Yahushua will welcome us into a home that lasts forever if we make friends. The true kind. Yeah?
Mm.
Go on. I just thought that was interesting.
Yeah, that's good, Tommy. Okay.
The Pharisees were listening to all these things. They criticized Yahushua because they all loved money. Yahushua said to them, make yourselves look good in front of people, but Yahuwah knows what is really in your hearts. What people think is important is worth nothing to Yahuwah. Before John the Immerser came, people were taught the law of Moses and the writings of the prophets. But since the time of John, the good news about you, Yahuwah's kingdom, is being told, and everyone is trying hard to get into it. But even the smallest part of a letter in the law cannot be changed. It would be easier for heaven and earth to pass away. Any man who divorces his wife and marries another woman is guilty of adultery. And the man who marries a divorced woman is also guilty of adultery.
Does that mean I'm guilty?
No. Because it's on the occasion of...
Sounds like a tradition thing.
Got you thinking there, huh?
put it to you, did that Dad instigate that?
Well, there's some who believe that if your husband or wife runs off, you should spend the rest of your life trying to win them back. Does that sound like a feasible thing to do?
No.
Somebody's put their foot down and said, I don't want you and I don't want Yahusha. I don't know the reference, but there's a verse that says if somebody does that, let them go. Leave them to Satan.
Mm.
Yeah. Or on the flip side, leave them to Yahusha to deal with. Yeah. Does that make sense? And you see, Yahusha had a bigger plan in what he was going to do with Mum and I.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Good eye.
Mm-hmm. Keep going,
Joe. Yahusha said, there was a rich man who always dressed in the finest clothes. He was so rich that he was able to enjoy all the best things every day. There was also a very poor man named Lazarus. Lazarus's body was covered with sores. He was often put by the rich man's gate. Lazarus wanted only to eat the scraps of food left on the floor under the rich man's table. And the dogs came and licked his sores. Later, Lazarus died. The angels took him and placed him in the arms of Abraham. The rich man also died and was buried. He was sent to the place of death and was in great pain. He saw Abraham far away with Lazarus in his arms. He called, Father Abraham, have mercy on me. Send Lazarus to me so that he can dip his finger in water and cool my head. I'm suffering in this fire.
Why can't you push it off?
But Abraham said, my child, remember when you lived? You had all the good things in life, but Lazarus had nothing but problems. Now he is comforted here, and you are suffering. Also, there is a big pit between you and us. No one can cross over to help you, and no one can come here from there. The rich man said, then please, Father Abraham, send Lazarus to my father's house on earth. I have five brothers. He could warn my brothers so that they will not come to this place of pain. But Abraham said, they have the law of Moses and the writings of the prophets to read. Let them learn from that. The rich man said, no, Father Abraham, but if someone came to them from the dead, then they would repent and decide to change their lives. But Abraham said to him, no, if your brothers won't listen to Moses and the prophets, they won't listen to someone who comes back from the dead.
It's interesting. Parable, isn't it? What did you get from that one, Mikey?
If we like, it doesn't matter how much like trouble and stuff people give us now, because when Yahusha comes back, if we just keep following him, we'll be with him and we won't have any trouble.
That's good. So man, rich man has everything he wants on earth. Poor man has nothing. Yeah? All he wanted was just some scraps. Just the crumbs that were on the floor. Couldn't even really get that, could he? Rich man was basically, nah, you're not having nothing of mine. Yeah? That's what it's telling me. Who's the rich man?
Satan.
In a way, yes. The rich man's a worldly person, isn't it? Yeah? Lazarus was a poor person just wanting to do the right thing. Just wanting to be able to eat something. Get rid of his sores. He dies first and gets put in the arms of Abraham. The rich man dies and gets sent to basically the pit of fire, doesn't he? And then he's begging. Let him come over here and dip his finger in water and give me some water because I'm burning. Well, what did you do while he was on earth? The roles have reversed, haven't they? Mm-hmm. Yeah? So Yahushua's saying to us, don't be like that rich man while you are on earth. Be like Lazarus. Mm-hmm. Yeah? Be humble. Be giving. Be caring. Be kind. Loving. For if you are like the rich man, you will go to the pit of fire.
Mm.
Yeah? Interesting way to look at it, isn't it?
Yeah.
So we don't want to be like the rich man at all. We want to be all the things that Yahushua was while he was on earth and still is.
Mm.
Welcome people with open arms. Give them Yahushua's love.
Yeah.
Show them the way that we live in Yahushua. Give them our understanding that we have from Yahushua so that they can change their ways. Yahushua will send us people who are just like Lazarus. We're not to laugh at them, make fun. That's not a quality of Yahushua, is it?
No.
Yeah? That's what he's saying to me in that parable. Don't do that. Not to anybody. Doesn't matter whether they've got money or they don't.
No.
You be nice to everybody. You be kind, loving, gentle with everybody. And see what riches you get when the time comes. Yeah?
Mm.
What else did you guys get from it?
I think there's a section here that refers back to how Yahushua is going to rise from the dead.
Yeah.
And how people didn't believe once he had risen.
Yeah.
When the rich man tells Abraham that his brothers would believe it, and then Abraham would went up and said, yeah, no, that's not going to be the case.
Yep. Fantastic point. Yeah.
Only somebody would come back from the dead to tell them. Well, who did?
Yahushua.
Who believed him?
No.
Not many. Who still believe him?
Very few.
So because you're confronted with that every day, the fact that you're in the minority, you are confronted with people, though, with riches every day, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
Whether it be in our place of work, whether it be you on your, what you're looking at, you know, like there's people with wealth. In the case of social media, people pretending to have wealth, pretending to be in the know. So you're confronted with that all day, every day.
Mm.
You've got to kind of have a, I don't know, a bit of a buffer, barrier between you and them and say, no, I know what I'm in. I'm grounded in the ocean. So, yeah.
Well, you've got to remember the promise that Yahushua has given us.
Hmm.
In that. So when you are out in the world, I mean, we don't have a choice. We have to be in the world. We have to work. We have to pay bills. We have to go to school. And that's all worldly stuff. Yeah, we don't have that choice because we need to be able to live. Yahusha sends everything our way.
Yeah.
As long as we are like Lazarus. Kind, gentle, loving. Yeah? And if we do the wrong thing, we need to repent and say we're sorry. Get it out. So that way, we are right with Yahusha. Yeah? We find, and I'm talking about Dad and I, that if there's something going on, whether it's between us or between kids or whatever, business drops. True?
If you're not on the same page.
And when business drops,
then he's got your attention.
It's money, isn't it? What's going on? Why? So then you're going through everything in your head, trying to work out what it is that you've done that's made it that way. Yeah? Same goes with you guys for school. Grades drop.
Consequences happen. Daily occurrences happen. Dramas happen.
Yeah? All of that.
Isn't Yahusha in every thought?
That's it.
It kind of ties together, that, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
I'm lost my place. Use the worldly things that you have now to make friends for later. Use the things you've got to do in your practical life to warn people. Not every single person. They just put billboard up. The end of the world is coming. The end of the world is coming. And that's ridiculous. But use every... Have your antennas up. Isn't that what we've been discussing about the offer of deliverance?
Yeah.
We've got brochures at the front counter now. We've tried to set up an area where people can come to.
And pour their hearts out.
It's not just the external things. We've had to become ready ourselves. Not be judging, not be angry, not be impatient. And we have to be the witness. It's our behavior, really, first that has to be right. Then he can send people to our worldly place of business. So it's a perfect example, isn't it?
Yep.
How much have you heard me complain about our worldly place of business? Rather be off doing something else. Yahusha's using that worldly place of business to make friends for later. So he knows what's happening later, and clearly we don't. So that's helped me. I'd never even seen that verse. Use what he's giving you in the practical, the daily chores, and like his mum said, the chores, and the jobs, and everything. Connect with Yahusha and possibly go, am I to warn this person? Am I to make this person aware of something? You have that question in the back of your mind all day.
And Yahusha will tell you yes or no. He will not lead you down the wrong path.
No.
Ever. You'll hear it and you'll know. Okay, I need to help this person. Yahusha's told me. And if you don't do it, you're going against what he's telling you. Yahusha gives us jobs to do, tells us what he wants us to do. He also tells us what we need to tell you to do. Because right now, you guys aren't fluent in this. Yeah? So the only way to get more fluent is by reading this, listening to us, because everything that we tell you comes from Yusha, and by practicing it, yeah, activating your seed. If you see somebody doing something that isn't right, doesn't matter who it is, your brothers, your sister, whatever. Hey, that's not right. Don't do that. If they don't listen, who's going to get the consequence?
Yeah.
That's right. That's exactly it. You are allowed to speak out if it is not right. And you know, and Yusha's told you, that's not right. If you don't speak out, you will get the consequence. And they will get away with it for a time. Until you actually do speak out about it. And I can tell you that because it's happened with me. I haven't spoken out about something, and I've ended up with the consequence because I haven't spoken out. And it's usually me getting migraines. All right? So I can put this to me as well, not just to you guys. Everything that is in here, I'm looking at it from me. It's about me. I need to be more like that and less like that. Yeah? So that's how we all need to look at these. Because this is all the living word of Yahushua. This is our food and drink for our spiritual life. Also for our worldly life, because if we don't live by this, we're going to destruction. So that's what we need to live by. Yeah?
Yeah.
Because this is the truth. If it's not in here, it's lies. It's from Satan. Yeah? So we can see everything that he's saying in every word that we read. Instead of thinking while you're reading, clear your minds and listen to what Yahushua is telling you while you're reading. I don't always get everything straight away, and everybody gets a different point while we're reading. You notice that? You got something different, you got something different, you got something different. We all get something different out of it. That's our abstract thinking that Yahushua's giving us. So don't have any preconceptions. Yeah? Like we'd welcome somebody with open arms, do the same thing while we're reading. Open mind. So that way we get the communication with Yahushua. And you'll know if it's what he's saying, because you'll feel it. You'll feel it in your heart, and then you'll be able to speak it. Yeah?
Yeah.
What do you think of all that, guys? Pretty powerful, isn't it?
Yeah.
And that's how we need to think from now on. Anytime something's being read, just clear your mind. You should give me something while you're reading. doesn't always come straight away, as I said, but it will come. Yeah?
Mm.
Fantastic. Alright guys, time for us to get ready for work. Have a great day. And we'll see you for another Bricky Bar soon.
Yes, ma'am. Things like this, Mikey, I want to change. I might bring the BY and V in every morning. Sometimes there's a way to better word it. So I want to go back from Matthew. Because this is a simpler version, but often in the BY and V, it's there for a reason.
Good morning, it's a beautiful day. Every good morning.